Hi, all of you. I am Dr. Rama Rao, Government Degree College, Tekkali, Srikakulam District. Today's topic is nutritional requirements for different stages of layers and broilers. In the poultry farms, the poultry feed convert into food products quickly, efficiently, and with relatively low environmental impacts. The high rate of productivity of poultry result in relatively high nutrient needs. Poultry requires the presence of at least 38 dietary nutrients in appropriate concentrations and balance. Cereals, grains such as maize, bajra, rice, etc. are some of the carbohydrate sources used in layer diets. The carbohydrates, proteins, fats, vitamins and minerals and water are the main nutrients in poultry layers that are discussed as follows: cereal grains, broken rice, rice polish, jowars, de-oiled bran, this is called as DOB, and wheat bran, etc. are some of the carbohydrate sources used in layer diet. Six need a high amount of protein, energy and vitamins and minerals for their starter period. They need more carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins and minerals to maintain good health and develop the body correctly. Boards drinking water about twice by weight of feed consumed. Water consumption is affected by environmental temperature, and the water regulates the animal body temperature and flushing out the unwanted wastes. Water is essential for the administration of medications, movement of feed through the digestive tract, breakdown of complex nutrients, and in the formation of blood, and is the basis for all fluids in the body. Many factors influence water intake, including environmental temperature, relative humidity, salt and protein levels of the diet, birds' productivity, egg production, cool, clean water uncontaminated by high level of minerals must be available at all times. The main requirement of the first one is the carbohydrates. Grains, grain byproducts, animal and vegetable matters are the most energy yield diets. The most common grain used in formulation of poultry diets or poultry feeds is maize. The principal energy source used in poultry diet in most of the countries because of its high energy values, palatability, easy digestion, low fiber values, presence of pigments and essential fatty acids. It contains 2400 to 3000 kilocalories per kilo, highest amount of energy among cereal grains such as maize, sorghum, wheat rice, broken rice, DOB, de-oiled bran, molasses, etc. It is added up to 70% of the prepared feed. And second one is proteins. The proteins is essential requirement into the poultry feeds. Particularly, this is a major component of the nutritional requirement in poultry farms. Poultry birds synthesize proteins that contains 20 amino acids. In these, 12 amino acids are referred to as the essential amino acids. Birds are unable to synthesize 9 amino acids because of the lack of specific enzymes. The amino acids mainly arginine, isoleucine, leucine, lysine, methionine, phenylalanine, threonine, tryptophan, and valine. These are the major amino acids in the protein molecule. Histidine, glycine, and proline. These can be synthesized by birds, but the rate is usually insufficient to meet metabolic needs, and a dietary source is required. Proteins yielding source are two types. First one is plant origin protein. In the plant origin proteins is soybean meal. It is the most commonly used plant protein in the poultry farms. The plant proteins contains to that cotton seeds, groundnut seeds, sunflower seed meal. It is used in grower poultry. These ingredients can be mixed up to 18 to 20% of diet. And the second one is that animal origin protein. The animal origin protein, it is the most commonly used are fish meal, meat byproducts, milk byproducts, blood meal, feather meal, and poultry byproduct meal. These ingredients can be mixed up to 5 to 8% of the dietary level. Third one is fats. The fats are available in vegetable oils. It yields 8,500 kilocalories energy from the de-oiled bran, mustard oil, palm oil, soybean oil, and sunflower oils. Vitamins. Vitamin premixes are commonly used to provide the required vitamins in poultry and then that poultry feeds. These vitamins are marketly available, particularly A, D, E, K, and BC vitamins. These vitamins are mostly the BC vitamin is soluble in water. These vitamins are added in the prepared feeds. Next one is that mineral supplement. The minerals are most sources of that calcium in poultry diets are ground oyster shells, limestone, bone meal, dicalcium phosphate. These ingredients are mixed up to 70% in manufacturing feed. According to the nutritional values in poultry chicks, The nutrition mostly proteins, minerals, and then the vitamins. These requirements for grower chicks, egg-laying chicks, and then that breeders. The protein levels it requires to that growers 18 to 20%, but in egg-laying 14 to 16%. Particularly in young chicks, it is that age is nearly 1 to 6 weeks, but in 12 weeks chicks, it requires to that 14 to 16% of the proteins for growers. So the protein level is slightly decreased. So at early stages, the protein is required more. And grower stage and then that broiler stage, the protein is comparatively less, nearly to that 2 to 3%. And then that mineral requirements, particularly calcium, phosphorus, sodium chloride, and manganese. These requirements at early stages, particularly in grower stages of that chicks, it needs to less amount, particularly 1.5 of calcium. But in that egg laying and then that breeders, it requires to more amount of calcium. It is added to that 2% of the total feed. And then the vitamins. In the total feeds, that vitamins it requires to 1%. The vitamin A, vitamin D, riboflavin. So this is also, these vitamins also at early stages it needs to less amount, and gradually it is increasing into that layers and broilers. Actually, there are three types of feed making for poultry feedings. All nutrients are available in powder form, pelletized form, and mashed form. The powder form, the required ingredient mixture, then according to feed formula, and it's make a powder form. This type of feed is economic, less investment to farmers. The poultry chicks are easy to this type of feed within 2.5 hours. Second one is that pelletized form. These are required hard and cylindrical shape and are being extensively used in India. Pellet size should be always 3 to 5 millimeters in this form. Normally, chicks are preferred to 6 to 8% of feed in pelletized form and quick or easy consumption. Feed conversion ratio is less in this pelletized form. And it is manufacturing of that pelletized form, most of that microorganisms it will perish, and then that toxicants can be eliminated from that high heat. The more nutrient values are protected in pelletized forms. Chick feed in less time and grow more. The feed conversion ratio is FCR. The feed conversion or food conversion ratio is very less. Next one is mash form. In this method of feeding, all the feed ingredients are ground, mixed in required proportion and feed as a single balanced mixture. This method is desirable for all types of poultry grown under litter and cage systems. Birds cannot have the opportunity to selective eating, and moreover, the quality of egg produced in uniform quality. However, ground feeds are not so palatable. The nutritional requirements of feeds at various age group chicks. So here we can see to that different types of feeds. It is divided into 7 types. For example, early chicken feed, grower feed, developer feed, pre-layer feed, pre-layer feed first stage, second stage and third stage. That feeds are divided into different categories, that is basing on that growth of the chicks. The use of feed in age groups. So mostly in the early chicks, it's requires to less feed. It contains 6 to 7 kgs per week. And pre-layer third stage, it's required to more quantity of feed, that it shows to that 51 to 72 kilos per week. That is depending on that size of the chick and then that body weight. And then it requires to that protein level. The protein level is higher percentage at earlier stage, particularly that chicken starter stage, and gradually that protein levels it will be lesser, particularly in this pre-layer stage, third stage. So it in this table that values is exhibit to that 20.5% at the earlier stage and 15.5% at larger or grow larger chicks. And then that energy levels also at the early stages it's more requiring. And then that crude fiber. In crude fiber, the chicken feed it requires to only 4%, and then that grower stage it is requires to 6.5% of the total feed. So this values particularly to that layers. And the second one is that broilers. In this broiler chicken, again that feed is divided into 3 types: pre-broiler starter, broiler starter and broiler finisher. These are the 3 varieties of feeds particularly using in the poultry farms. So here itself we can see that feed consumption is less in pre-broiler starter and then more consumption in broiler finisher. And then that crude protein level is also at early stages it needs more. 22.5% of crude protein it is required to growing of the chicks. And then that 20% of the crude protein it requires to that broiler finisher. And then that crude fiber level is almost all same. In this table it is shows to that only 4% of the crude protein it's required into that pre-broiler starter and then that broiler starter feed and then that broiler finisher feed. Thank you, one and all.